This meeting to order. Welcome, everyone. Ms. Fishinghawk, would you do us the privilege of the invocation, please?
Stand, please. Please bow your heads. Dear Lord, we come before you this evening to thank you for all of your blessings. We thank you for your grace and mercy. We ask you, Lord, to be with us this evening as we consider the business of our people and grant us the wisdom to do your will. I ask you now to guide each counselor's heart tonight, that we may conduct ourselves in a manner pleasing to you. I also ask that you protect our troops in harm's way and keep them safe. Bless each home represented here tonight, and thank you for your continued blessings upon the Cherokee Nation. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Ms. Fishinghawk. Roll call.
Here.
Bill John Baker.
Here.
Jack Baker.
Here.
Arlie Buzzard.
Here.
Julia Coates.
Here.
Roger Cobb.
Stephanie.
Joe Crittenden.
Here.
Jody Fishinghawk.
Here.
Meredith Fraley.
Here.
Janelle Fulbright.
Here.
Don Garvin. Chuck Hoskin Jr.
Here.
Anna Glory Jordan. Mm-hmm. Curtis Snell.
Here.
Chris Stokes.
Present.
David Thornton.
Present.
Eric Callen Watts.
Honey.
We have a quorum.
Madam Speaker.
Yes, Mr. Buzzard.
I'd like to amend the agenda.
You make a motion to amend the agenda?
Yes, I do. I'd like to.
Do I have a second?
Second.
Moved in second.
What for?
For amending the agenda.
Yes.
Having discussion on amending the agenda. All in, for what purpose, Mr. Buzzard?
I'd like to table item number one under old business. At this time, I'd like that in the form of a motion. Come in.
We're amending the agenda, so that's the purpose of amending the agenda, correct?
Yes.
Okay. All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All opposed, same sign.
No.
Madam Speaker, I'd like to make another amendment to the agenda. I'd like to do these in toto. A resolution authorizing the Bureau of Indian Affairs to revise and update the Cherokee Nation inventory of the Indian Reservation roads. Number one, a resolution for access and utility easements and service line agreements over across in upon USA and trust land for the Cherokee Nation in Rogers County, Oklahoma, AKA Cherokee Casino property. Number three, a resolution authorizing approval of land assignments to Tibbs Family Trust for 1 acre, known as the Sunset Garden Cemetery, and quick claim deed to record owner of property not containing the cemetery. I'd like to make those in the form of a motion.
You want to amend the agenda to include those items?
Yes.
Second
the motion to amend the agenda to include those items. All in any discussion? All in favor? Mr. Van Horn?
Would that be 6, 7, and 8?
Yes, 6, 7, and 8 under new business, correct, Mr. Buzzard?
Yes, ma'am.
Buzzard?
6, 7, and 8 under new business.
All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All opposed, same sign. The agenda is amended. Okay, next order of business is approval of the February 11, 2008 minutes.
I move they be approved.
Second.
Moved in second. Any discussion on the February 11 minutes? Any discussion? All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All opposed, same sign. Next order of business is State of the Nation, Principal Chief Chad Smith. Good evening, Principal Chief.
Good evening. It's my pleasure to appear in front of you and the Cherokee people on this March 10th, 2008, in the state of the Cherokee Nation. Let us start tonight by honoring our fellow Cherokee citizens and special friends who have passed away this month. We have a long list. Susan Blackbird, Lucinda Black Backwater, Lizzie Adair, our employee, and everybody enjoyed seeing him come from the mailroom, Don Guy, James Fishing Hawk, Arthur Keener, Nanny Carter, Pansy Crawford, Jerry Crawford, Jess Tidwell, Eddie Pittman. I'm sure there's others. If you will, join me in a moment of silence. And remember them and think about their families in need at this time. We have two veterans to honor tonight. The first is Tom Felix Ryder. He's born in 1918, 4 miles north of Salisaw in the Badger Lee community. His parents are Tom Needles Ryder and Tiny Mae Rigsby Ryder, both original Cherokee enrollees. In 1941, Tom was inducted into the United States Army. In 1944, in New York Harbor, Tom boarded the Queen Mary, where he was assigned to the 121st General Hospital. Tom and his fellow troops would soon become responsible for setting up hospitals and motor pools in England, France, and Germany. While Tom was in England, he was in the middle of the German Blitz, where the Germans were shooting buzz bombs from France across into the English Channel into England. Tom traveled with a medical detachment to Germany, which had been completely destroyed by American bombers. He said the only things left standing were the churches. Tom ended his service with the United States Army, being honorably discharged in 1946, having received the rank of Staff Sergeant. In 1947, Tom married Echo Garvin in Fort Smith, Arkansas. Tom and Echo owned and operated a business in Salisaw and had a horse and cattle ranch in the Miller Ridge community northeast of Salisaw. Later, Tom was employed by the Oklahoma Tourism and Recreational Department until his retirement in 1983. He and his wife of over 60 years still own and operate the horse and cattle ranch in Miller Ridge. As a side note, Tom is the uncle of Tribal Council member Janelle Lattimore Fulbright. So at this time, Mr. Ryder, if you'll come down and let us acknowledge our appreciation of you.
It gives us great pleasure and honor to present you with the Cherokee National Medal.
Care to say a word, please? Like to say something?
Thank the good Lord that he brought the Cherokee warrior back home.
Thank you. They want to. I think they want to pinch you. Oh. Last month, we honored Wilson Van. Unfortunately, he became ill with the bug that's been going around and had to leave. So tonight, we present him with his military award from the Cherokee Nation. He's born in 1924 in Short, Oklahoma. Wilson's parents were James W. and Lila Van, and his grandmother was Nancy Scott. Wilson attended school at Rock Fence in South Greasy. Shortly after Wilson turned 18, he joined the United States Navy. Wilson's first duty assignment was on the amphibious personnel destroyer ship. His ship was docked in Nagasaki, Japan, just 3 weeks after the dropping of the A-bomb. After the Navy, Wilson worked in the Cessna Aircraft Company in Wichita, Kansas, where he met his wife, Loretta Reiner. They will celebrate their 60th anniversary this year. Wilson is a grandmaster in the martial arts world of Taekwondo. He's a true 8th degree black belt certified by the World Headquarters of Taekwondo in Seoul, South Korea. A true credit to the Cherokee Nation, Mr. Van continues coaching and encouraging young people in the martial art and the discipline. A true gentleman, and we're very delighted to show our expression of gratitude to you, Mr. Van. Will you come down? Thank you.
picture?
Those two together?
Absolutely.
Mr. Ryder, if you'd come over. It's a rare occasion, and what are your wives too, that we have two couples that have been married 60 years. That's really quite a...
Some program highlights: the new Three Rivers Health Center in Muskogee is now open for business. The new Will Rogers Health Center in Notwater is also open. I encourage everybody to drop by to see these beautiful facilities. Each building is decorated with Cherokee art and history for a designated period. Last week, nearly 100 school districts in northeastern Oklahoma received a total of more than $2.8 million from Cherokee's car tag revenues. Over a period of 5 years, the Cherokee Nation has contributed more than $13 million to school districts. The Health Department's Cancer Program held and hosted a cancer summit last week in Tulsa. Many medical professionals presented and attended the conference. A highlight of the presentations was a panel of cancer survivors. Some of these survivors were helped by the Cherokee Nation's health services. More than 250 people attended this conference. I want to thank our healthcare employees for their excellent work. And if you recall the basketball game between Sequoia and Keys that same night, was Think Pink, and the cancer survivors were acknowledged with roses after the girls' game, and the girls' basketball team presented those roses. The Cherokee Nation's Community Services held a training session for about 100 people from 30 different community organizations. These workshops help these groups get organized and work effectively so they can better serve those in their community. I want to congratulate Sequoia Schools for the thrilling games that they have given us in the last few months. And we all know the score from Saturday night came up a little bit short. But I'm reminded of a great quote in a movie called Coach Carter. And there was a conflict between the coach and the superintendent. And the coach is going to suspend some of the kids for disciplinary actions. And the superintendent says, "You can't do this. This will be the highlight of their life if they miss this." And he turned to them and the superintendent says, "You know, that's an awful sad statement, that this becomes the highlight of their life, a basketball game." And I say that to say this: when you see our girls and our boys play basketball, you know that will not be the highlight of their lives, because they are just now demonstrating the leadership, the drive, the confidence, the things that will make them much more successful in their later endeavors. And I want to share this with you, because the girls had the opportunity and came up 3 points short to be the fourth state champion in a row. And it's an article that appeared in the Oklahoma City paper yesterday. It's a short article, and let me read this for you. Caption: showing why they're Oklahoma's team. The line started forming at 8 a.m. on below freezing morning. They came from Tahlequah, the home of Sequoia High School. But they also came from towns and hamlets not so close to Cherokee County. They came to see the Sequoia Indians, Oklahoma's team. American Indians come from all over the state, sometimes all over the nation, to watch Sequoia girls and boys play basketball. Quote, "I was following Sequoia long before I moved here," end quote, said Augusta Smith in her second year teaching college prep at Sequoia. Quote, "Arizona, Alaska, Virginia, people were still talking about Sequoia," end quote. Sequoia fans helped pack the State Fair Arena on Saturday, more than 10,000 strong, to watch their teams play Class 3A state championship games. The Sequoia girls, trying for an unprecedented fourth straight girls championship, were upset by Millwood 63-60. The Sequoia boys played Verdigris later Saturday night for the title, which they also won in 2003. Quote, "We're, quote, more proud of them than ever," end quote, said Cherokee Nation Chief Chad Smith after the Sequoia girls stood and watch Millwood's trophy celebration. Quote, they've always been great students and great athletes, but win or lose, their sportsmanship, their leadership, that is why we have Sequoia High School. They have left their legacy, end quote. Sequoia is an American Indian boarding school run by the Cherokee Nation, but students from many tribes attend the school, and the fan following is the same. Quote, amazing what basketball brings to your life, end quote, said Babette Dotson, who lives in Anadarko and works at Riverside Indian School, but latched on to these Indians when the current seniors were ninth graders. Dotson reported a Hammer Time t-shirt in support of Sequoia senior Lauren Hammer, who scored 17 points and whose 50-foot heave at the buzzer was online, but just a foot short. Quote, I'm here because of the girls, said Dotson. Their uniqueness, they're all Indian girls. Said Augusta Smith of Creek Seminole, this is our team, our Indian people. Chris Goodrich of Stillwell, the uncle of Sequoia star Angel Goodrich, estimated between 20 to 30 family members were at the State Fair Arena on Saturday to cheer on the Indians. Hammer's father, Dwayne Hammer, doesn't know how many family members were in attendance, but he knows the people who came from Dallas, California, Washington, D.C. for this tournament. He knows how many Hammer Time t-shirts he had printed. All 45 were accounted for by family and friends. Indian families, they're close, said Chris Goodrich. Somebody does something, they'll support them the best they can. Like me, I hear about a good Indian team somewhere, I go watch them. Every Indian's proud of their heritage. Of course, winning does not hurt. In 1998, the first time we went to the state, we waited in line 4-5 hours, Jeff Wakachi said. During the playoffs, we sold out to Muskogee Civic Center. Sequoia basketball fever has been spreading ever since. Quote, a lot of folks save up their vacation time for the first week of March, quote, said Chief Smith. End quote, it's the highlight of the calendar year. I just wanted to share that article with you because that's in the state's largest newspaper. That Sequoia is the state's basketball team. That's good stuff. It speaks of the leadership of Sequoia and the guidance and support that this council has provided for a school that 9 years ago was known as a school of last resort, and now it's the school of first choice. The Cherokee Nation Marshal Service raised almost $6,000 for Special Olympics. They plunged into the Illinois River during the Polar Bear Plunge event last Saturday. Our group was honored for being the law enforcement group that raised the most money. Cherokee Nation partners with Tulsa's Junior Diabetes Organization. They will be hosting a gala benefit on April 28th in Tulsa. We invite you to support their efforts to fight juvenile diabetes. The Juvenile Diabetes Organization has raised almost $1.3 billion in the last two decades to fight the disease that is crippling our children. Before tonight, and I hope that our webcast is being communicated as usual, because I think we all can do this together. It is the birthday of Keith Danner. He's our employee that was in IT. He's currently serving in Iraq. So, if you went with me on the count of three, happy birthday, Keith, and maybe he can pick it up in Iraq. One, two, three. Happy birthday, Keith. Wadeau. Thank you.
Thank you, Chief Smith. Next order of business is action of unfinished business, and there's none pending, so we move to committee report. And the first report is David Sutherland, Housing Authority.
Good evening.
Good evening.
I have a brief report this evening. The Housing Authority's regular board meeting will be held a week from Tuesday on the 18th at 5:30. The meeting, as always, is in the Allen Hogner Administration Building Conference Room. The board's agenda is pretty light this month. They were had a full agenda last month and approved several items related to the transition of housing programs. They did approve a four-week payment to any employee who chooses to voluntarily separate from the Housing Authority for whatever reason, doesn't matter. We've had eight folks that have chose that option. The board also approved a four-week recruitment incentive for any employee that accepts a non-comparable job offer. We have approximately 25 employees that have accepted non-comparable job offers. We've down to four employees that have no offer that would like an offer, and we're confident that that's going to change this week. So we've been working hard on that. We've had two job fairs with CNE, CNI, and the Cherokee Nation all conducting interviews with employees. That's been quite helpful for CNE and CNI standpoint and Cherokee Nation's. But we will continue our efforts until all have received a job offer. May 1st, as I've stated, I think last month, is the date of the transfer of employees. Our Community Shield program, the premium renewals went into effect on the first day of March. The annual premium for a stick-built house is $346, and a mobile home is $424. Both of those went up $3 over last year's annual premium. We have 2,200 families participating in the Community Shield program, so real good program we have, and we're quite proud of it. But that's my report for the evening. If you have any questions, I'd sure try to answer them.
Any questions, Mr. Sutherland? Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Mr. Stewart, David Stewart of Cherokee Nation Enterprises.
Good evening. January, as usual, was busy for us at CNE. Our numbers were slightly below budget and slightly behind last year, but still very good. Our dividends were $2.4 million to the tribe, and our sales tax and excise tax combined was another $86,000. We're about to top out West Siloam with the steel, so that celebration, although it might be small, is going to happen in the next week or so. We continue to see price pressure on all the construction costs for all the projects that we're trying to re-engineer, so we're battling that as well. Our current job count is almost 3,300. 71% are Native and 58% are Cherokee, so those numbers are increasing. We continue to work very diligently on that effort. We kicked off our new website, CherokeeTourismOK.com, so check that out. And our employees contributed 14 bags of goods for the PACE program. We just picked that up today, so our employees are very active in what's going on at the Cherokee Nation. That would conclude my report. I'd be glad to answer any questions.
Any questions for Mr. Stewart? It's not.
Thank you.
Sorry, Mr. Thornton, do you have a question?
David, do you know in vain, are you ahead of the game here on this proposed federal gaming rules that's coming out?
Yes.
Would you mind reporting to us in committee on that?
Yes, I can.
I don't know what they're about, and I'd like to know what they're about.
Okay, I'll be happy to do that.
Thank you.
All right, thank you.
Thank you, David. Reporting for Cherokee Nation Industries is Dennis McLemore, their financial officer. Mr. Collins, I understand, is in Washington, D.C.
He's somewhere. He's keep moving around on last week, I think he was in Las Vegas, but this week he's in Washington. Good evening. As of February, we had $6.8 million of sales for the month of February. Total sales, approximately $33 million for year-to-date, which is about 30% less than the comparative period for last year. Local employment, we have 290 people, 82% of which are Cherokee. And we have a total of 242 Native American, and 237 of those are Cherokee. Our next board meeting will be on March 31st, be held in the Tulsa office. That's really the end of the report.
Nice and short. Thank you, Dennis. Any questions or comments for Mr. McLemore? Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Next is Cherokee Nation Businesses. Do we have anyone reporting for Cherokee Nation Business? Guess not. We'll move on down to Old Business, which has been tabled. The item one under Old Business is tabled, so we move to New Business. Item one is a resolution authorizing a $70,000 grant to the Family and Youth Services. Mr. Buzzard,
Yes, I make that the form of the motion.
Second.
Moved and seconded. Any further discussion? All in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All opposed, same sign. Item 2 is a resolution authorizing a $100,000 grant to the Department of Health Services for victims of family violence. Mr. Buzzard.
Yes, I also make that the form of the motion.
Second.
Moved and seconded. Any further discussion? All in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All opposed, same sign. Motion carries. Item 3 is a resolution approving the Articles of Incorporation of Cherokee Nation Community Association. Ms. Coates.
Yes, and I make that in the form of a motion.
Second.
Moved and seconded. Any discussion? All in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All opposed, same sign. Motion carries. Item 4 is a resolution authorizing a $1.5 million three-year grant application to the Department of Health and Human Services for Native Americans. Ms. Coates?
Yes, and I make that in the form of a motion.
Second.
Moved and seconded. Any discussion? All in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All opposed, same sign. Motion carries. And item 5 is an amendment to the 2008 fiscal year budget. It's Mod 5. Mr. Baker.
Yes. This budget mod has an increase in the budget of about $2 million to reduce it to $437 million for the year, due primarily to adjustments in the tobacco surtax and the housing authority. But it does include an increase of $400,000 for a new roof at the J Clinic, as well as $317,000 for the tribal bridge projects. I make that in form of a motion.
Moved and seconded. Any discussion on the amendment to the 2008 budget?
Yes.
Okay, all in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All opposed, same sign. Motion carries. So move on down.
Act by unanimous consent.
Yes, by unanimous consent. Moving on down to announcements. I know we have one announcement for.
You got your other third.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm in a hurry. The new items. Item 6 is a resolution authorizing the Bureau of Indian Affairs revising and updating the Indian Reservation roads. Mr.
Yes, I'll make that in form of a motion.
Second.
Mm-hmm. Moved and seconded. Any further discussion? All in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All opposed, same sign. Motion carries. Item 7 is a resolution for access and utility easement. Mr. Buzzard, do you have
that? Make that in form of a motion.
Second.
Any discussion? All in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All opposed, same sign. Motion carries. Item 8 is a resolution authorizing approval of land assignments to the Tibbs Family Trust for 1 acre. Mr. Buzzard.
Yes, make that in the form of a motion.
Second.
Moved and seconded. Any discussion? All in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All opposed, same sign. Okay, now I've gotten anything else. Okay, moving on down to announcements. I know we have one announcement by our youth tribal council who's here tonight, and that Mr. Lowe, Jason Lowe, he represents Three Rivers. Do you want to come and make an announcement at this podium here so they can hear you? Thank you for coming.
Thank you. The Cherokee National Youth Choir will be having a My bad. I got mixed up. Okay. The Cherokee Nation Tribal Youth Council will be having a benefit / contest powwow on March the 29th at the Sequoia Gym. And all everyone invited. In the old gym, not the new, in the old gym. And it's the gore dancing starts at 2. And it just in Green Entries at 7, right? And I just like for everybody to come that can come.
Thank you. Thank you for coming tonight. Mr. Garvin, did you have a comment?
Yes. Last Saturday, I had the honor of going to one of their meetings, and it's outstanding what they do and the things they accomplish. I learned a lot from watching them.
Great. Any other announcements?
Yes, I have one here.
Mail?
Delaware County Inter-Tribal Youth Council, their 8th annual contest sponsorship powwow. We help Friday, April 4th and 5th. Jay High School Bulldog Arena, Jay Obama. Pre-admission, open to the public. Thank you.
Thank you. Ms. Kamlots?
Yeah, I have two announcements. If you could mark your calendar, we will be having the Eastern Band, Cherokee Indians, and Cherokee Nation Joint Council on April 9th, which is a Wednesday. The Joint Council will be video streamed, but we'd also like to invite you, and we should have plenty of room for public at the Cherokee Casino in Tusa, and that'll be in the salons. And again, that's Wednesday, April 9th. And yes, we need the First Lady there. If Smith hasn't told you, I saw the look. But the other thing is, we also have a women's conference on Saturday, April 19th from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. And if you don't have the information on that, it should be coming out in the Cherokee Phoenix, and we do respectfully request an RSVP by April 11th. That conference is free. Former Chief Wilma Mankiller has graciously agreed to moderate. First Lady Bobby Gail Smith is our chairperson for the event, and it's the Cherokee Women's Grassroots Leadership Group that's been meeting for over 3 years, and we appreciate Chief Smith's support in making the whole event possible at the casino in Catoosa on Saturday, April 19th from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m., and it's going to be an outstanding event, and I look forward to it. Thank you, Madam.
Thank you, Ms. Kamlots. Any other announcements? Before we move to adjourn, Mr.
or not.
Mr. Carson, do you have a report since we're ready to adjourn now?
That suggestion, perhaps I can give two reports next month.
All right. Thank you. Motion and a second to adjourn. Any discussion? All in favor, signify saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye